Hello and welcome back, everybody, to another episode of War on the Sea, playing as the United States Navy. Well, no updates from last time we left it. We are taking over the Santa Cruz Islands, we have lost Milne Bay, and we are yet to make an assault on Guadalcanal. Our planes are moving about. That's very, very well. And I will return once there is some action. And speaking of action, let's try and go after the... this submarine here. New air, Avengers, death charges. Let's try this for a change. If it works, great. If it doesn't, I hope it was at least fun to watch. Interesting. Ask for 16 wasp. Let's see what we got. We have 11 Avengers. We're gonna go with rockets. Tactical here. And attack. No damage. Shame. Was worth a shot, return. So let's focus on this task force up here. And let's get both. Kingfisher return to base. Let's go. Now all Avengers. Start. Break, form up. Down on the deck. Dauntless attack. This guy. So that is probably the best view. Probably this is the best view, actually. So let's go. Thank you. not my hottest idea. That is 2-3 Dauntlesses and 2 Avengers. But it looks like we're gonna get 2 destroyers in return. Critical, moderate, sunk, critical, heavy. And we need to get that cruiser sunk. Oh, and we actually have the chance. And it's all ahead, flank. He's on 15 knots. Distance 55,000 yards. Hey, that's gonna take a while. Let's see if we can make it. Turn on radar. Turn on radar. Let's see if we can get them. 53,000 yards. Actually, a fair chance. What I will do to facilitate this, I will take a cut here and return if I can intercept them. We have intercepted the transport column at least, and we are starting to bombard those 3 transports. Have already scored hits quite early on. And looking at the rear, over there is the smoke from the other ships that we are trying to pursue. So we are not gonna go full ape over this, but we are going left and right of these 3 transport. They're insignificant with the... Why is it still firing? Hold fire. Secondaries, manual fire, Empire, like so. Distance of about 8,000 yards. Yeah, and we are scoring pretty good hits consistently. Although it's mostly the Dewey. Let's go after this guy instead. Plenty of shells. Eight and a half thousand yards. Good hits. We can range that in 9,500 yards. We can't. Tracking, tracking, tracking. The Dewey. And all ahead, flank. Hey, Yuri is giving her some grief. South Dakota. I know this is probably overkill. Fire. Rounds out. Hold fire. Pretty close. Fire. Rounds out. Secondaries. Secondaries have opened up. Very good. Nothing else on radar. To clarify, have we sunk? We sunk one of the destroyers. Another one is still out there. We have sunk two merchants. There is a heavy cruiser and a destroyer out there, but that's nothing the South Dakota couldn't handle. Yui is going like so, yeah. Go ahead, Yui, full speed ahead. And this is the South Dakota cruising. Can get a couple of rounds out with the secondaries, but I doubt it. No, it's just outside the that should get it into range. Yes, here we go. Direction 300. Ding 311. Okay. Will be a tough one. Will be a tough one. Definitely worth a try. Now, fire. some good hits here. Yeah, wonderful. As the last transport slips beneath the waves, we are still trying to intercept at least the heavy cruiser that is limping north. So I will take another break here and return when any interception is going to happen. And we have just detected the wounded destroyer. And USS Dewey has started opening up on her. Only a 30% solution, but she is essentially stationary. 7 knots is nothing to write home about. And USS South Dakota is joining with her 16-inch guns. So, manual fire. Round one out. Holding fire. Yeah, she's pretty much stationary. Targeting her. Yards. Waiting for the 16 inches to... And even before the 16-inch shells land, we have another ship sent to the bottom of the sea. So, back to USS Dewey and ceasefire. Let's see if there's anything on the horizon. There's still splashes. be from the bruiser. Very difficult to see anything, but them's the brakes, and all we can do is continue heading in a northerly direction and hoping we will intercept. Let's go for that. And we have indeed detected that cruiser. Can't see it yet, even in our binoculars. And there it was. Flashes from the cruiser's guns. So USS Dewey, radar guided, 46%. Let's open up. Not manually, fire at will. SS South Dakota. Start targeting her. 13 knots. She does not have a chance. And she's not even targeting the South Dakota. It's 24,000 yards, so that's where we can lose the first round. She is doing 13 knots. Oh, she is actually firing at us. Okay. We could take offense. Fire one. And hold. No. Was doing that too early. Fire. Loading. Let's see where it lands. I would say that was not too bad for an aim. And I think we managed to disable her engines. Very good. She is burning. Let's quickly identify her as who she is. A heavy cruiser. And it is a Furutaka class. Identified as Furutaka class, heavy cruiser. Yep, she is dead in the water. So, fire at will. ...17,000 yards out. We are aiming at the front part of the ship. Let's get these rounds out. Come about. Cease fire, she is going down. So yes, it was worth pursuing them. And we have a clean sweep. All ships that entered the battlefield have been sunk. Minor damage on the South Dakota. What is it? Nothing that we didn't have before, actually. So, yeah. 10 out of 10 would recommend. That is all for today's video. Thank you so much for the continued support, and I will all see you on the next one.